Hey, it's Halloween Scary Figs. Halloween Scary Figs. We're not even come up with this. It doesn't matter. Because we are here to look at Michael Myers, the ultimate Michael Myers from Halloween, the most recent. Here's the back right there. It's showing you all the lit poses you can put him in. You can take him to the graveyard. You can take him to your living room. Wherever you take him, make sure you don't forget to light up your jack-o'-lantern. Check that out, you guys, on the back. Look at this. It even comes with the police officer head right there. We're going to get this open. And the cool thing about these NECA figures, man, you got these little Velcro piece. So if you want to keep it close, if you want to keep it shut, you can do so. And right there, there's all those accessories. Look at that. You're getting six in all, because if you count the ones that are already on the figure itself, six interchangeable hands. We got the jack-o'-lantern right there. We got that police face that I was telling you about. You can interchange these as well. And it looks like you're getting also a knife, a hammer, and I believe something to put out the fire. Let's find out. Let's get them open. Let's get this figure going, because this one is one that needs to come into the collection. There's only been one other Michael Myers figure that NECA has put out. It's that one right there. We are going to do a quick comparison. I'm going to tell you this right now. From the get-go, I'm noticing that, well, actually with really any Michael Myers, any just figure in general, since they've redone most of these, because a lot of them they had put out, they lacked articulation. Like for this one, I think only has maybe about seven in all points of articulation. You're getting so much more. Here's the tombstone right there. It says Judith Myers, born November 10th, 1947. And when's the end date? When is the expiration date? October 31st, Halloween Day. That's sick, man. I like how, and that's another thing too. When it comes to NECA, they always go crazy with the, like all the shadowing effect that you're seeing right there, it's scattered all throughout the tombstone. Not much on the back. I mean, you can still see a little bit how they try to scuff it up to give it that real look to it. But the figure itself right here, check this out. Let's get them out. The way that they have this right here, it's not a zip tie, but all you got to do is you got to twist it. You got to play with it. You got to mess around with it until it finally, the trick is to figure out which way they have it twisted, because some of these have it like they'll start out going to the right and then all of the suns it turns to the right or to the left. It's out, don't worry, it's already out. I want to take a look at all the accessories first, because there is so much with these figures, man. It makes sense why they're marked up a little bit more. They do have it up on the NECA store right now, on the eBay store, on the Amazon store. Look at the police officer, you guys. I want to see this one first, because this one I feel like it's going to have most of the detail. Look at the mouth, dude. This kind of has like that Joker inspired theme where it's all ripped up, all up by the cheek area. Look at that. By the nose, it's missing part of its nostril. The eyes are completely gone. Now this thing can be lit. There's a hole right there. As you can see all of the insides, man. I guess if your pinky was small enough, you might be able to fit it in there and do like some thumb wars. I guess that would be pinky wars, right? The hair, it's got some really, really, really nice shading, man. All throughout in the back, up top. Here's the interchangeable head that you can pop it onto. Both of these, actually, you know what? They actually look quite similar. I noticed that the hair piece on this one, it is more like slick back. This one is kind of like, dude just woke up and he's ready for the day. Oh my gosh. So we'll pop that one on before we do. I want to take a look at the light up jack-o'-lantern right here. Pretty sure this one lights up. I think how you do it is, how do you, oh, that's right. You push it down. So when you push it down, you can actually see the inside light up. Sick, man. That is cool. And actually, it kind of fades in and out, kind of like a real jack-o'-lantern. Kind of like, if you hold it down, it'll stay on. If you push it back in, it'll go off. That's sick, man. Really nice. All these accessories that this figure's come with, dude, it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. But not as beautiful as the weapons right here. The one that I had for my old one, I had to improvise. I bought that loose, so I ended up using one of those knives that came with, I think it was Chucky. Here's the hammer. The hammer right here, it looks like the top right there, it's got some really nice red paint deco, and then the bottom of it has like a grain wood effect to it. Really sick, man. Here's the knife. The knife right there, this is the one that we're gonna need, man. But we are gonna have to interchange the hand in order to see what it will actually look like with the figure, because the ones that are on there right now, they are open hand. And here's the little piece right here that's gonna put out the fire. Look at that. That's sick, man. It's really thin. You can easily lose this, so make sure you put it in a nice little safe spot to make sure that you don't lose it. Here's the hand that you're gonna need for the knife. It's gonna be these bottom ones. Let's put these all aside. So all in all, we're getting one, two, three, 4, 5, 6 six accessories in all. And then, like I said, 4 additional hands apart from the ones that are already on the figure. The ones that are on the figure right now, they are an open hand design. These ones right here, these ones are going to be the in-close. These are the ones that you're going to need to put on the either the hammer or the knife. The other two ones right here, I'll bring them up close so you guys can see it. These ones are open hand as well, but they are a little bit wider. The opening on both of these are definitely a lot more wider. So, and actually this one is actually missing part of its thumb right there, or its pinky. It's missing two of his pinky, or his pinky and his inner and his ring finger. That's his ring finger right there. The detail involved in these, man, that's sick. Really love this. You can see all the nails, all of like the line work of an actual like decayed hand right there. This is the one that we're gonna need for that knife. And again, you do get two close fisted. They both do look pretty similar, except this one, the right one is covered more. It definitely has more of the shading to it. So we're gonna pop the right one. I feel like he holds it with his right more. I'll have to go back, I'm pretty sure. But the right one is the one that we're gonna use for this one. Now the peg, the way that these pop out, you guys, the peg is gonna stay on there. So you gotta make sure that you check it out and you slide it in there and it should just go. That's your left one, man. That's the left one hero. Or no, it's Halloween here, scary figs, right? Today's Halloween scary figs. And it's gonna try to go into the side right there. So you gotta make sure that you align it and then push it in there. Like so. Come on, don't fight me. Come on, Michael. Of course he's gonna fight me, dude. He's Michael Myers. And she goes in there just like that. So you are gonna have to play around with it a little bit in order for that to sit right, the knife right. Now we gotta pose, just like how they have it right there on the inside of the picture. Now we gotta pose the right way. Look at that, dude, he's coming down those stairs. This guy never dies. Doesn't matter how many times you come after him with, whether it's like a gun, whatever it is that you, yeah, you can't keep this guy down. He's just gonna keep coming back. Scale comparison with the old one, here it is. I do feel like the old one, it is just slightly a bit taller. And I think the reason why is because the way that he's like permanently posed. And this is what I mean permanently posed. You can't bend these legs. They're just set into one place. So if you plan on doing anything else besides this pose right here, if you know, it's him charging at you, it ain't gonna work. And of course, the actual, like the whole suit, it's like a light brown as opposed to the blue. It makes sense. Different movie, different time, different era. So I don't see why they wouldn't, you know, go with something different. So the mask right here, as you can see, this one, it looks like, I mean, they both did a great job. NECA has always done a great job with like the paint deco that they've applied to all their figures. But if you want some more current right there with the bright white as opposed to like that dark gray, this is gonna be it for sure. The hair piece, again, these ones do, this one does come with an interchangeable one. If you want that same similar look that we're seeing with this one, you're gonna have to pop it out. The head, it pops out a lot easier. I think the hands are the ones that are mainly the struggle. So you're gonna see all the struggle, the peg right there. It does just, as you can see right there, there's a small hole. You just find the little hole and you push it down and there she goes. Look at that, it sits flush. You can turn this 360 degrees. You can turn it all the way around, but we don't have to pull a Chucky on you. For the shoulder articulation, they do come out about this far. They go all the way around. There is no upper bicep swivel, but you are getting elbow right here. The swivel at the elbow, kind of like how they do like the basic figures for the WWE line. You are getting double hinged elbows, so you can get like more than 45 degrees. For the wrist, again, you can turn them all the way around. They do go slightly forward, not all that much, and they do go back about yay much. For the abdominal crunch, there isn't one. There might be one underneath the coat. It's hard to tell. There is one in there, actually. I can actually feel it. You can see that it hunches about this much forward. You're getting most of the articulation. It does have like a waist articulation where you can turn it, but the thing is that this coat right here hinders it. The legs do go up pretty far. I mean, all of these NECA figures, you can almost perform the splits. The right one does seem to go out a little bit further. They go about this far forward and this far back. For the knees, we are getting a single hinge right there, and it only goes about this far back. For the ankle right here, we are getting the full ankle articulation. You can pivot side to side, forward and back. So articulation, again, it's just a mile ahead of what they were doing back then. And I'm glad they did, because this one, man, it was getting really outdated. Not so much the attire. This, I actually prefer this attire. This one brings back more of those good memories. But regardless, having this articulation width. It's like one thing you could do. I mean, if you want to get like old school with it, because the attire right here, that the long one-piece suit, it's very similar. You could do a repaint. I'm sure we'll see some customizers out there that are into customizing these NECA figures. You could repaint it to this like this dark grayish brown, and I could see that, you know, being executed with the hair. Again, this one kind of does have more of that look. You wouldn't have to go in there and repaint that white to that dark gray, but solid figure, you guys. I'm gonna rank this. I'm so happy to have this. That Mezco one, man, that is a pocket breaker. This one is a lot more. It's a fraction of the cost, so it's finally nice to get this updated into the NECA collection. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel, and we'll see you on the next one.